Well, hi everyone. I'm going to be doing some seed saving today, and I thought I'd show you what I'm going to be doing. Now, I'm going to start out with, I'm going to be doing some jalapeno peppers, and I'm going to be doing some lemon drop peppers. This is the first year I've tried these. These are very, very good. Got a little bit of a lemony flavor. This year for my peppers, and I'm hearing this from a lot of people, that peppers seem to be very, very hot this year. I know we can hardly eat these, but they are very good. I've also tried something new this year called quinoa. If you're not familiar with it, this is a grain very similar to amaranth, and weather conditions were pretty rough this year, and I really wasn't sure of how any of my seeds were going to turn out, but so far on my tests, they're doing very good. But the quinoa, you know, I really wasn't sure. But, you know, I collected what I could, and then yesterday I soaked them overnight to get the coating off of it. Quinoa has kind of a coating on it that is supposed to be bitter to the birds and stuff, so that and the birds don't bother them. But the weather was very cool and very wet, and I wasn't very sure that my quinoa was going to work out. But I did collect some. I thought it was too late, but evidently not, because I soaked them and they started sprouting. So evidently my quinoa is good. This is very good because I've got about 4 quarts sitting in there now. Probably would have had about 8 quarts if I had gotten it when I was supposed to. Now for the coup de grace. That's a zucchini. Yeah, I'm going to be saving seed with it. I did have a couple of others out there that I got out already, but this thing is 20 inches long, and that's something like, what was that, 52 centimeters. And at the biggest point around, it is 18 inches, which is about 46 centimeters. I'm going to be saving seeds out of it today. But I wanted to talk to you about something else on seed saving. I consider it to be very, very important. I actually consider it to be an emergency. Something people need to be aware of. And I'm going to be posting this on several seed saving sites and organizations that I am subscribed to or a member of or something. Because if you're not aware of this, you need to be aware of it. This has to do with the new European Union seed laws. Now, you may sit there and think, well, I'm not European Union. Well, you've got members in your seed groups that are members, are living in European Union member countries. And I'm hoping that they'll see this if they're not aware of what's going on. And you need to be aware of it, because this is a worldwide problem. I'll be honest, I'm of the opinion that they are doing this on purpose, but it doesn't matter. It could be that the powers that be are just very, very stupid. I don't believe it. Like I said, I think it's on purpose. It could be stupidity, but it doesn't matter. The end result is the same. And what it is food control of your seeds. I'm going to put a link in the description box to a site in the UK, and I hope all of you will go and check this out. But they enacted this May 6, 2013. Well, they passed the first draft of it, is what actually happened. And there was such an outcry about what they were doing that they watered down the everything a little bit, but they left wording in there to allow them to go in and change things later. Well, they're doing it. Really, I can't go through everything, but I strongly suggest go check this out. This affects everybody. It's taking place almost everywhere under different conditions, different situations. It's affecting everybody. In the United States, we've got cities that are bulldozing people's yards because they're not allowed to have a garden. Many other things. You can go look those up for yourself. And I strongly suggest you do if you're not aware of it. Heirloom seed companies. You may not be aware of it, but the heirloom seed companies in the United States, many of them are owned by subsidiary corporations of Monsanto. Now, put aside what we may believe about GMOs being unhealthy. What I see as greatly important as that they are bringing everything together under one control unit. And here is what is happening here with the EU. Is the big seed corporations supposedly have been pushing for this law. This is food control, people. Food control has been used as a weapon in wars all throughout known history. Farms were put to the torch during wars. Food stocks and supplies were destroyed. Something is happening. Now, you don't have to agree with me on this. I don't care if you only see it as these people are just being stupid in what they're doing. Like I said, the end result is the same. What is happening here is they are once again reclassifying seeds. It used to be that seeds were commercial seeds or they were amateur seeds. There was another category, I can't quite remember exactly what that is. But see, amateur seeds were heirloom seeds, generally heirloom seeds, bred for the average home gardener. Well, they're trying to do away with this. All seeds before were supposed to be registered with the EU. EU, not your country. This is the EU. And this is making me so mad that I can hardly talk. But this website is a seed company that I generally try to order from. They cost a little bit more than some of the others, but one of the reasons why I buy some of my seeds from them each year is because they are very, very involved in all of this and trying to learn and educate people. They teach people to save seeds. Strongly suggest you check out the website. But they want all seeds to be registered now under the commercial category. Now, commercial seed companies sell seeds by the tons, tons and tons and tons. They can afford this. But you see, the small farmers, small people such as myself and very likely you, don't use these seeds very much. We go in for some of the other things. But what it happens is that it costs nearly 3,000 pounds. We're talking in the UK here. But I don't know what it would be in euros. But 3,000 pounds to test and register one single variety of seed for sale. And these smaller seed companies cannot pay this kind of thing. See, this is part of what was part of the first draft, and then they reworded stuff to kind of calm people down. And they knew back then they were going to do this because they are reenacting it. If you are part of the EU, you need to read this. It is in English. Of course, if you're watching my video, this shouldn't be any kind of problem. They've got links on here to go and contact your representatives and stuff. Now, I'll put a link to another video down here if I can find it. That may tell you just how useless that might be, but at least we can try. But write to you people. There are petitions that you can sign over the internet. And for those who aren't in the EU, look in your home countries. This kind of thing is being enacted all over the world in varying degrees, in different manners. But your food supply is being controlled. I started my channel calling myself the self-sufficient life. And I call myself the self-sufficient life because nobody wants to watch a channel called Take Personal Responsibility for Your Life. Well, that's what self-sufficiency is, taking personal responsibility for your life. I refuse to be dependent on any government entity or organization for the welfare of my family any more than is absolutely necessary on my part. I can supply a large majority of my own food for my family. And see, so can you. These people know it. If you're playing at gardening, you need to get serious. Because whether or not it's on purpose or stupidity, the end result is going to be the same. Take steps to get self-sufficient. Be personally responsible.